have with me right now Mr. Dave Obole, who is co-convener Movement Against Occupation. You're welcome to Sunrise Daily.
Thank you very much, Markwe.
Well, you have listened to the concerns of Miyeti Ala, as spoken by Mr. Ngazama, with my colleague in Lagos there. What are your thoughts on the reaction of Makban to the law prohibiting open grazing?
Yeah, it's important to build a background and a framework for all of this discourse. For 6 years now, specifically from 2011 to date, Benue has come under spotlight globally because of issues of, invasion of our communities, killings, destruction of lives and properties, by Fulani herdsmen. And as I speak to you, out of the 23 local governments of Benue State, 15 local governments were attacked, and some of them were actually occupied with these Fulani people living there and feeding, their cattle from our bands. And as I speak to you, nothing less than 3,000 lives have been lost and properties worth billions of naira has been destroyed, because of this crisis. The continuous insistence of the Fulani people to graze their cattle on grasses that have been watered by the blood of Benue people and grasses that have been manured by the corpses of Benue people is something that is very, very appalling. And from 2011 to date, when the crisis heightened, to another level, we have been pursuing the issue of dialogue and advocacy. I have personally been in Abuja on two occasions to present a memorandum to the National Assembly committees, one on agriculture and the other on the police, on this particular subject matter. The Benue people have been crying out to the federal government, lives matter in Benue State, and you need to do something to ensure that Benue lives are also protected. Our farmlands are our heritage, and agriculture is our mainstay as the people of Benue State. That is why we've earned a reputation as the food basket of the nation. But as I speak to you right now, if not for the implementation of the law, which seems to bring a light, at the end of the tunnel, Benue people have been so afraid to go to their farms because of incidences of people being murdered in cold blood in their own farmlands. And Benue's reputation as the food basket of the nation is put to question right now because that basket is almost getting empty of food because of this particular situation. When, let me set this in proper perspective, that we have enjoyed a good cordial relationship with the Fulani people who have grazed their cattle on our land for many, many years now. But from 2011, that relationship assumed a bloody dimension. And that is when, from Agatu to Zakibian, that's like the A to Z of Benue State, this invasion and killings began. So we began to seek, for a culturally relevant and more sustainable solution.
Did anybody find out the root of this particular conflict? I mean, you talked about how you had a cordial relationship up until 2011.
Yes.
At 2011, what precisely happened?
At 2011, like I said, these cattle began to encroach into the farmlands of people. Prior to that time, they were grazed by the sidelines and not encroach into the farmlands, to eat up the crops. From 2011, we discovered that their desperation pushed them into entering into farms and then eating up crops that are yet to be harvested.
Their desperation, was it a situation? Because we've also spoken to experts who talk about how, the north, northern part of the country, even further into the Sahel, is getting drier.
That is what has caused the desperation.
We've noticed, that there is a larger influx of cattle into...
Downwards, towards the south.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So we see that happening, more often. And we also see that the population in the south is also expanding and that the international cattle grazing routes, which used to exist traditionally before now, are also being encroached upon. Have we been able to verify that this indeed is the situation?
Actually, like you rightly pointed out, the encroachment of the desert in the north is actually occasioning their influx into the middle, where there is still fresh grass for them to graze. And their influx downwards now It's important to note also that the land is a fixed asset. It does not grow or expand with the increasing population. When we talk about what used to obtain in the 50s and in the 60s, the game is different. It's a different ballgame right now. Population, you know, right now, vis-a-vis the 50s and the 60s, is so different. It has exploded considerably. And therefore, this land is not enough for the cattle and the human beings, the cattle and the farmers, to cohabit peacefully any longer. Therefore, that's why I mentioned the words culturally relevant and sustainable solution to this.
So would you say that that was exactly at the root of the conflict between farmers and herdsmen in Benue State?
The root of the conflict is their desire to have their cattle graze. But in the course of perpetrating their businesses or carrying out their businesses, they began to encroach into the freedom of others.
So it wasn't political?
Yeah.
Was it political?
There are dimensions to this. There is a political dimension to it. There is an economic dimension to all of this too. And maybe with time we'll be able to, you know, look at those dimensions. There are political dimensions to it, and then there are...
That's what I'm asking. I mean, in the course of investigating the root cause, did you find that there were any political considerations or any religious considerations? Was it simply economic and a matter of survival?
It's a multi-pronged, you know, issue. There are religious dimensions to it, there are political dimensions to it, and there are economic dimensions to it.
But primarily, what did you find? What was the outcome of the investigation that was carried out?
All of these factors actually interplayed in this particular situation, as far as the Benue situation is concerned. Let me pick this issue up one after the other. When we talk about the religious dimension of this, Benue State is less than 1% Islamic. That makes us like 98 to 99% Christians, broken into, you know, the various, you know, families within the Christian communities. We notice this trend that any of the local communities that have been invaded, all of the mosques will be standing, but all of the churches will be pulled down. That's a religious dimension to it. And we see it as a continuation of the expansionism of Islam via jihad. So this is a veiled jihad now that is trying to impose Christianity on this occupied, you know, territories of Benue State. Because actually, when they invade these territories of Benue State, they don't just do a guerrilla tactics of hit and run. They actually are bold enough to stay in these communities after they have been sacked.
There's only one community we know of, unless, of course, you want to mention another one. I mean, and that was a Mon community in Kwande local government area, which we heard, you know, was attacked and later on occupied. Now, we still do not know the status. I mean, I don't know if...
Local governments like Buruku.
But which other local governments?
Buruku local government.
Yes.
Have been attacked and occupied. Agatu local government was attacked and a portion of Agatu was also occupied.
Is that still the situation till today?
That is still the situation until the implementation of this law. Like you heard Ngazama say, as I speak to you right now, about 10 million cows or cattle have reportedly entered Nasarawa State. That's from, you know, their press conference yesterday. And what's the population of Benue State? 4 million people and 10 million cattle live in Benue State. That means the population of cattle in Benue State is much more than the population of the human beings. We are outnumbered 2-1, or at least 2.5 to 1 person, you know, as far as the cattle population and human population is concerned.
Now, so you are seeing... There will be questions as to why, for instance, cattle, because if you say that the conflict is just... is an economic conflict, you know, between farmers and herdsmen, there will be questions as to why, you know, communities, entire communities will be attacked in the process. Did things get out of hand?
Actually, if you look at this situation, Benue for them is no longer a state, but just an arena of profit and loss to be able to further their own cattle cartel or cattle business. You know, the Fulani man, for him, cattle is his symbol of status. It is the life of the Fulani man. And whatever they will do to ensure that their business goes further, even if it is at the expense of lives, that is what has played out from 2011 to this. So it is in the furtherance of the economic activities that this invasion and occupations began to happen. So that's the economic dimension to it. Mm. You know, their desire and their insistence to graze their cattle and to continue their economic life, you know, from this cattle, you know, the cattle products and so on. The cattle need grasses to grow. The cattle need grasses, you know, to produce the milk and every of the things that enhances the economy of these people. So that's the economic dimension.